ऑनरेबल चीफ मिनिस्टर श्री अरविंद केजरीवाल जी, ऑनरेबल हेल्थ मिनिस्टर सत्येंद्र जैन जी, अमित सिंगला सेक्रेटरी हेल्थ, डॉक्टर सरीन, मेंबर्स ऑफ द फैकल्टी ऑफ ILBS, ऑन कंप्लीटिंग दिस जर्नी ऑफ 11 इयर्स विद ग्रेट एप्लॉम्ब आई कंग्रेचुलेट यू. It's been a wonderful journey. You all have made a name for yourself, as the Honorable Chief Minister said, not only in India, but even outside. So it should give a lot of satisfaction to you, your faculty members, and your students who have come and worked here. As you mentioned in your inaugural, liver diseases are as common, if not more, than the heart disease, sadly. Both public awareness as well as treatment and research facility in this otherwise preventable group of diseases have been lacking. Hepatitis, alcohol, and obesity injure the liver most, sometimes irreparably. Loss of life and growing need for liver transplantation associated with limited awareness and lesser availability of cadaveric donors in the country is it a matter of great concern. As the Honorable Chief Minister has said, Angdan may probably help. Therefore, we should try and take it up as one of the agendas for future. I'm happy to note that in this institute, in a short span of 10 years, you've given hope to millions of people by providing state-of-the-art patient care at the most affordable cost. I've also been told that ILBS had been a destination to more than 100,000 patients last year. 100,000 patients last year. So I'm glad to learn that it has established a successful liver and kidney transplant program. And till date, 716 liver and 229 renal transplants have been performed with reasonable success. I do hope it shall remain a role model and develop the best clinical protocols and operational systems as per the industry norms. The Institute has taken a lead in organ donation program awareness and organ banking. The only thing is that now you should also take up the task of telling the society why organ donation is important in this field. It gives me great pleasure to announce that during the current ongoing COVID-19, as you have been told, ILBS, despite being a dedicated super specialty facility, took the initiative of establishing a state-of-the-art COVID viral testing lab, which was the first one, as the Honorable Chief Minister just mentioned, in the city, the nation's first centralized plasma bank for enabling ill patients to avail plasma therapy. Dr. Sareen, a Padma Bhushan awardee, has done commendable job since the establishment of this institute. I compliment him and his team for the relentless endeavor and selfless dedication for raising the bar of excellence in healthcare through this super specialty medical institute, which can match any institute of global standard. Congratulations to you, Dr. Sareen, and your team. Since I have this opportunity to talk to some eminent and other budding doctors, I'm tempted to flag a general issue outside of the ILBS concerns, a general issue for your consideration. With changing times, we are witnessing a paradigm shift in the doctor-patient relationship. The patient today is much more aware, demanding, and armed with search engines-based knowledge. In fact, sometimes too well informed for his own good. Many a time he has to be engaged in long-winded conversation also. He does not accept physician's advice as gospel truth. Many of you would readily agree with me that a lot of patients now are extremely impatient. And this, coupled with heightened emotions at the time of illness, could lead to unpleasant situations. The earlier prevalent feeling of mutual trust and respect between the doctor and the patient seems to be waning. This needs to be restored. And this, in my opinion, is possible by better understanding and realistic expectations from the patient and relatives and empathy from the physicians. I do realize this is asking for the moon in our society simply because the number of patients you are required to attend in a given time, it's so much that you can hardly ever give more than 10, 15 seconds. Even then, I have no option but to reiterate that patient you are dealing with is a human being carrying his baggage of emotions, fears of the unknown kind, and psychological peculiarities and prejudices. A kind word spoken, a patient hearing, or a pat on the shoulder always acts as a booster to medical intervention. Therefore, dear friends, it will be a good idea to re-establish the old thinking. When a patient went to the hospital, he thought of the doctor as a god, if not god, at least a demigod. And even if the things did not go right, most Indian families would blame it on the god and not the doctor. So let's try and get back that relationship. I'm sure ILBS, which has done some yeoman work in different fields, would also establish, if you have already done it, I'll be very happy to know that. With these words, I conclude by wishing the Institute every success in the coming years and assure my due encouragement and support for its bright future. I am there for you, wherever you want, whenever you want. I will be very happy to meet Dr. Sareen and his team. And then we can, in whichever way, we can help the Institute to grow further. And as the Honorable Chief Minister said, it should become one of the best known institutes in the field of biliary and liver matters. Thank you very much once again. God bless you. Have a wonderful future, even better than what you have had in 10 years. Maybe you get more. Thank you once again for giving me this opportunity talking to you.